Can you explain to people who've never heard what a circadian clock is, what it is, and why it's so important?
Yeah, so all lives on this planet evolved under a rotating Earth. So that means for 12 hours, approximately 12 hours, they had access to light. And for another 12 hours, they were in darkness. So that environment, that changing environment, put a tremendous pressure for them to come up with a timing mechanism so that they can anticipate when it's going to be evening or when it's going to be morning so that they can time their activity and sleep accordingly. So that's why almost every organism on this planet have this internal clock that help them anticipate time. And why this is important is if you think about a diurnal organism or an animal that's active during the daytime, the animal has to anticipate when evening is going to come so that he can rush back to the cave or somewhere, some hiding place. So similarly, just before the dawn, this animal has to wake up before even light hits and then go out and get the first grub. So that's why there is this tremendous pressure to have this biological clock or internal timing to essentially anticipate what's going to happen. So for most people, we know when we go to bed, maybe after 6 to 8 hours, we wake up. So our clock actually tells us, yes, it's going to be morning, get up now. So similarly, almost every part of our body has clocks that help us to anticipate when the food is going to come, or when we are supposed to run, or when we are supposed to take rest. So what we are learning is almost every organ in our body has a clock, and it helps this organ to be at peak performance, peak activity at certain time of the day, and then to rest and rejuvenate at the other time of the day.
So is this internal biological clock, the circadian clock, it's not something that we're just immediately born with, right? It's not something that just...
Yeah, so when you are born, we kind of... So when babies are born, they actually don't have this daily 24 hours rhythm and activity or sleep. They don't go to bed for 6-7 hours. So what we suspect is although they have a clock, those clocks are not wired together. And at the same time, babies also need a lot of food and because that's their growth phase. So during the first maybe 4 to 6 months, the babies wake up in every 3 to 4 hours, cry, eat a little bit and go back to sleep and then wake up again and do that. Then after 8 to 12 weeks, they actually begin to have some kind of consolidated sleep. So they go to sleep and wake up at the right time. Wake up after a few hours, but it's not tied to light-dark cycle, so they kind of drift. So that's a phase many parents may not notice because we now live in a very artificial environment, but that's the time when there is a clock, but it's not tied to outside light and dark cycle. So around 6 months of age, that's when the whole development process ends. The clock is functional, it's tied to light-dark cycle, it's wired properly, so the babies go to bed, hopefully in the evening, and then sleep for 9 to 10 hours, wake up. Mm-hmm. So when we are born, we do have clocks, but they are not connected together until about 4 to 6 months of age.
Oh, interesting.